just one of us including them we are facing the altar. It is Jesus Christ who today is in the center, and this exchange of marriage vows will take place within celebration of the Holy Mass. That's why I'd like to welcome
in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Be attentive to our prayers, O Lord, and in your kindness pour out your grace over these your servants, archless and clean, that coming together before your altar today, they may be confirmed in love for one another. Grant me to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Dear brethren, stay standing as we welcome the Lord of the world.
She reaches out hands to the and extends her arms to the needy. Charity is deceptive and beauty is fleeting. The woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her a reward of her labors. And let her works praise her at the city gates, the word of the Lord.
Thank you.
The second reading. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, live in love as Christ loved us and handed himself over to us. Be subordinate to one another out of reverence for Christ. Wives should be subordinate to their husbands as to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, just as Christ is the head of the church. He himself is the savior of the body. As the church is subordinate to Christ, so wives should be subordinate to their husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ loved the church and handed himself over to the over for her to sanctify her, cleansing the church by the bath of water with the word, that he might present to himself the church in splendor, without spot or wrinkle or any such thing, that she might be holy and without blemish. So also husbands should love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself, because we are members of his body. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and his mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. This is a great mystery, but I speak in reference to Christ and the church. In any case, each one of you should love his wife as himself, and the wife should respect a husband. The word of the
Finally, this long-awaited day has come.
Pronounced conscientiously, slowly, and distinctly.
take thee, isn't it? First to?
First.
If anything, should we be pronounced with fear and trembling? With fear and trembling, but with deep faith in the Lord, who alone can sustain your money, who alone makes the two people to become one. So it must be pronounced with faith. To this solemn declaration, the church pronounces the authoritative words of the Master, saying, what God has joined together, what is not let no one put asunder. And we all respond, amen, amen. Now let it be so. Let it be so. With this, when we think of everything, Achilles and Jacqueline shall become one flesh, as we are in the second reading in the Gospel. And shortly, and indeed, as we sang in that hymn after the first reading, they will no longer be two, but one. And no one should separate a great mystery indeed. And so what is required is perseverance and fidelity. Perseverance and fidelity. Achilles and Jacqueline, the sacrament calls for fidelity and perseverance to each other till then. In the letter to the Hebrews, chapter 13, verse 4, the sacred word of God says, let marriage be held in honor among all, and let the marriage bed be undefiled. Achilles and Jacqueline, this is what you have done today. You have come here so that your relationship is raised to the dignity of the sacrament of holy matrimony, which makes you from today on husband and wife in the name of Jesus, and confers upon you the grace to love each other with the love in which Christ himself loved his child. Today you are also, so to say, given a license to enter into the production industry. Isn't it? And into the mining industry. Today you are given a license. Be fruitful and multiply, is it? From today on, be fruitful and multiply. Of course, I know that you have already done this, but it was illegal, you know. By the way, all those who are engaged in this industry, and yet have not yet taken this system, they are illegal miners. Those are called what?
Illegal miners.
And unfortunately, they are not a few. They are not
illegal.
Achilles has lived with so many illegal miners behind. Taken the degree of faith. You have chosen to walk the path that may they fear to tread. Thank you for accepting to march into the arena where many fear to bear. There is a big graduation ceremony or feast today in heaven as well, in your honor. Big ceremony. Today, you cease to be spectators at mass. You become active participants. You know spectators know the game better than the participants. Listen to me. Brother Robin is seated and watching. Today, you become an active participant. Welcome. Welcome to the altar of the Lord. You are declaring today that you have fallen in love with each other. You have fallen in love with each other. Remember, marriage requires falling in love many times. Falling in love always with the same person. Falling in love many times. Falling in love always be the same person. The same person. Whether 40 years, 50 years, 70 years, you should keep on falling in. Yeah. Falling in love. In the morning, falling in love. In the afternoon,
falling
in love. In the evening,
falling in love.
All the time,
falling
in love. Falling in love. In the morning. I know that the world is falling, is it? So you don't have to reflect, it's just falling. So you fall, you keep falling in love with the same person. Today you are saying, I choose you. Actually, he's saying gently, I choose you for so many. Because you have seen in the heart that good woman described in the first reading. So don't come around tomorrow and bring these stories to test. So your daughter is like this. For us, we need test, so we give you keep on. Likewise, Jacqueline is saying, Achilles, I choose you, and I will continue choosing you over and over again. You are both saying to each other, I vow always to love you, even during the football season. When I said, if you play or not, I always story is told of a husband who went with his wife for supper. He called dinner out and he called him for a beer. He called beer. So when he got his beer, he raised it up. He said, oh my darling, I love you. The wife looked at him and said, are you talking to me? The husband said, no, I'm just talking to my beer here. So where has love now shifted? To a beer. No longer. Is why. So we're saying every morning we should say to each other, I don't care what happened yesterday. I am going to love you today. I'm going to love you today and tomorrow. So love, 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 as the second reading emphasizes. According to Pope Francis, the joy of love experienced by families is also the joy of the child. So your joy as a family is our joyful families make a joyful church. And you can tell in the church the one who has no joy in the family. We pastors can tell. And others are clapping. Then you know this one at home. No, what? There's no joy. So bring joy to your families so that you can bring this, that joy also to the church. So actually, and Jacqueline always try to make your money a joyful one. Doing this by doing simple things like greeting in the morning, a touch, affirming each other in public, planning it together, a smile, and so on and so on. Only that gently is a cover of not joy to smile at each other. That is what keeps your marriage going. That is what attracts the other, so that you can fall in love again and again. We don't want to see perpetual Good Fridays. For their faces. Actually, there should be no perpetual Good Fridays for their faces. What are we saying here? That you treat each other as a gift. Treat each other as a gift, but different from the other. So cherish each other and accept each other as he or she is. No one should be seen as a burden. No one should be seen as a burden, but as a gift. He gave the stories he told of the husband who went for prayers. He might have heard. This was preaching about burdens, offering their burdens to the Lord. So he went back and banged on his wife, put her in a basket, carried her to the priest and said, "This is my burden." No one should be seen as a burden, but a gift. And do not forget the three magic words if you have to keep your marriage happy. One, in the words of Francis, may I thank you and sorry. And then serve all this on the table of prayer. Well aware the family that you pray together stays together. So pray together and you will stay together. As your friends and gathered here as a church today, we want to make our room the prayer made on the night of the wedding of Tobias and Sarah. And what was that prayer? May the Lord of heaven give you a happy life together. And may he grant you happy holy day together. And all of us respond.
Amen.
Again.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Let me invite Achilles and Jacqueline at the front of the altar.
You move it. I'm not going to
sacrament in the spin a woman pay. Kati, Agati, Wane, look, Wane, Kibabu, in which I'm teaching Wane, 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 ye graduation ya mukukiriza atena ndaba mubereno ye sacrament ari nega ya yoge ndira ya yoge kwa kuche na gama ati jeshi ne ache muri no kwa barana kumacha owe kulo kutumbi ndira ya yoge akeli akeli mzakzejo kusevi na mbogi
Let us rise and offer our readers with a similar post-mortem.
I call upon these persons here present to witness that I, at least to the girl, do take you, my love, Jacqueline, to be my lawful wedded wife, to have an abode from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer and poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us apart.
Jacqueline, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.
Spirit. Amen.
Thank you.
In a similar way, when his supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Let us pray, dear brothers and sisters, to the Lord for his bride, Jacqueline and groom, Achilles, who come to the altar to begin their married life, that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, they may always be bound together by love for one another. Holy Father, for the one in your own name, male and female, you created them, so that us as one and wife united in body and heart, they might fulfill their calling in the world. Oh God, who to reveal the great desire you formed in your love, will that the love of spouses for each other should foreshadow the covenant you graciously made with your people, so that by fulfillment of the sacramental sign, the mystical marriage of Christ with his church might become manifest in the union of husband and wife among your faithful. Graciously stretch out your right hand on this your servant, Achilles and Jacqueline, who pray and pour out into their hearts Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Having been many partakers at your table, we pray, O Lord, that those who are united by the sacrament of marriage may always hold fast to you and proclaim your name to the world. Grant you through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated for a minute. Dear brothers and sisters, we are coming almost to the close of the celebration. In the church, we have very many important visitors in this church, but let me just concentrate on those who are at the altar. So first of all, I would like to thank the choir, sort of the Catholic Diocese, like the Association Choir. Let us clap for them. Celebrating this Holy Eucharist. As you see, we have very many priests coming from different sides of Uganda. We are not able to mention all of them, but please allow me just to mention the diocese they are coming from, and I kindly ask those of whom I'm going to mention to stand up. We have very many priests coming from Soroti Catholic Diocese. Please welcome. I think it's the biggest number. We have a priest coming from Masaka Diocese. Welcome, dear priest. Yes, welcome, Father. And your priest from the hosting diocese, Kampala Diocese. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for working with the couple, but more especially, we'd like to put our hands together and to thank the main celebrant of today, Bishop Joseph Echino. Thank you very much, dear people. Imagine Bishop King even yesterday and he spent the night here in New York to be ready for this wedding. Thank you very much. You always welcome here at Munina Marti Shrine. Dear brothers and sisters, in the Catholic Church, we have a very beautiful tradition that at the end of the exchange of vows, at the end of the Holy Mass, the newly wedded couple goes with flower to Mother Mary. Bishop was preaching that family which prays together, stays together, and this young couple is going to start praying right away from this very Mass. So we are going to ask Bishop to give us the final blessing. Immediately after the final blessing, the choir give us a song to Mother Mary. The newly wedded couple will spend a few minutes, a few seconds, giving the prayers and intercession from Mother Mary, and then they will come immediately after to sign the marriage registry and certificates. Thank you very much for coming, and thank you for praying and witnessing to this holy marriage. The Lord Bishop will ask you that you give us the final word and the final blessing.
Let us also thank Father Male for hosting us, for your love and your respect. Thank you very much. As a pastor here yesterday, we accommodated here free of charge. Thank you indeed, Father Male, and to all of you, Archives and Jacqueline. Thank you for bringing us all the way from Teso to Thessalonica. The church there greets you and wishes you every blessing. The Scala members who are here, you there, who have come to accompany Jacqueline Scala, that is the Soroti Catholic Diocese Lady Association here in Kampala. Thank you so much for coming and for being witnesses to this historical event. Let us rise up for the final blessing. The Lord be with you. May God, Eternal Father, keep you of one heart in love for one another, and that the peace of Christ may dwell in you and abide always in your home.
Amen.
May you be blessed in your children, have solace in your friends, and enjoy true peace with everyone.
Amen.
May you be witnesses in the world to God's charity, so that the afflicted and needy who have known your kindness may one day receive you thankfully into the eternal dwelling of God.
Amen.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you now and forever.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord in your life.
Thank you. Judiciary fraternity, are you here? Ah, where are you? John Paul Semagana is also here with us. Thank you, Father. As well as Father, what David John Mary has joined us on this special occasion. Let's love the Father Joseph over again. Ladies and gentlemen, every one of us is welcome, and the Lord Judges, the Lord Justices, every one of us, but many provisions will be made at Kololo. But for now, ladies and gentlemen, let's recognize the team from Mora. Let's hear that from our standard from Mora. There they are. At this time, allow me to invite Tony Bondo to recognize the members of Parliament who have been part of the bridal entrance and every one of them that is here. Thank you very much. My name is Stephen Mayongwe, Councillor Mora. Thank you.
Thank you very much. We don't have time, so my role here is to introduce members of parliament who are here and the ministers quickly. I will start with the members of IALA and the right honourable speaker who is here. Our right honourable speaker of the East African Parliament, right honourable Joseph Tukwilichimana, is right there. I have Honorable Paul Samali. I have in the meantime, as I'm introducing members of Parliament, we are calling upon the family of Archons to come and take a picture. Please join me quickly. We have Honorable Makosa. We have Honorable Kadoko. We have Honorable Dr. Seranda. Those are the members who have come to join us in church today. The rest is joining us in Kololo. Allow me now to recognize ministers who are here today. The Honorable Minister David Baji, Minister of State for Trade. Minister Helen Adora, Minister of State for Fisheries. Minister Grace Mugasa, State Minister for Public Service. Allow me also to recognize all members of Parliament, Honorable Sesi Wamede, Honorable Isaac Otingu, Honorable Nalima Ethel. We have Honorable Kenny Paul Chaka, Yachonde. Honorable Kamatenity Justice. We have Honorable Agnes, Member of Parliament. We have Honorable Engineer Chokedu, MP for Luka. We have Honorable Auma Lika Agnes, MP for Lira. We have Honorable Achucho Jacinta, for Capelio. We have Honorable Nakakuta Brenda, MP for Kalilo. We have Honorable Achan Judith, Peace, MP for Loya. We have Honorable Achok Alonso Joan, MP for Soroti City. We have Honorable Achale Juliet Lebro, MP for Nara. We have Honorable Nadeno Zumura, MP for Kote. We have Honorable Achilo Pasca, Meja, MP for Padel. We have the Honorable Dr. Lydia Namer, MP for Kitgum. We have Honorable Natu Maria Flora, MP for Chikube. We have Honorable Nairon Bishajel, Uman MP for Ibanda. We have Honorable Laura Bilira, our MP for Kulisa. We have Honorable Shamsi Sherure, MP for Magola. We have Honorable Tracy John, MP for Nyaruguru. We have Honorable SNU, Akoli, member for Kapelio. We have Honorable Kisebo, MP for Kibale. We have former members of Parliament who are here, who are with us. There is Honorable Paul Miru. There is Honorable Safia Nalule. We have Honorable Violet Akurut. But we also have our member of Parliament for the elderly, Representative Yanov. She's here with us.
Wait, wait, what are you doing? Congratulations, Rebecca!
Thank you.
bannaffe mwenna babadde naffe mwebalire ddala omukolo gwali gutebegulabise nga wanemunyonyo tugumaliriza era kakati ndowooza tusisinkana ekkololo mwebale nnyo mwebalire ddala babadde naffe ekkololo tugenda kubeerako nnyo temuvaako tujja kubeerako ngondwe Gerard nze mbadde ku kamera. In fact, cameras, channels, tubadde ne channels bbiri wali zombi zibadde ziweereza live naye tugenda kwongera era okubaweereza bwe tunaabanga tugenze ekkololo era tugenda kubeerako temutukoowa bannange mubeereeko mwebale nnyo mwebalire ddala erinnya asigadde ngondwe Gerald James Ntege ali mu control naye ng'ate era abadde ne ku kamera ey'okubiri mwebale nnyo mwebalire ddala mubeereeko bannange. Bye-bye.